for me, I found that just engaging very intensely with Max and working with him and playing with him and just trying to really treat him as a normal child and just you know, really relish the experiences that we have, you know, and really actually even appreciate them, I feel, more than a regular parent in some ways. Everything that he can do that, you know, some people would just take for granted is actually really amazing. So when he goes out and rides his bike or goes skiing or, you know, does these different kinds of physical activities that, you know, traveling, all these things are things that really take on a greater positive importance because, you know, of what he had to overcome and to be able to do that. Really, it's, you know, there is no alternate reality there. This is what you have, and so that's always been my approach, is just to say, deal with the situation that you have. It's not worth worrying about the way things could have been, because they're not that way, and there's a lot of things in life like that. And so, yeah, I think you just have to take it day by day and appreciate what you have.
I think Max himself also really helps us to stay positive. Yeah. He's just this incredibly exuberant, enthusiastic, happy kid. And one thing I've noticed is when we are dealing with a difficult situation, like if he gets hospitalized, we find that we'll talk to family members and they'll have such sadness in their voices. And it's stressful for us to be hospitalized. It's not something we look forward to, but we find that there's often this disconnect where we're not feeling quite as down, and I think it's because we have Max in front of us who, if he's not undergoing a medical procedure or being hooked up to an IV in the hospital, he's out riding a skateboard around on the hospital sidewalks. And so I think his whole attitude, he's got this major condition, he's got a lot to deal with, but he's incredibly positive and happy, regardless.
Yeah. Before we had Max, we traveled extensively. It was a big part of our professional career. We're both professors, and we get invited to speak often overseas, and we really enjoyed that aspect of our lives. So, you know, when we had the situation with Max and the medical condition, you know, we basically assumed that would be it for our travel. But one of the big turning points, we feel, in our psychological well-being and everything was a trip we took when Max was about a year old to Paris and got invited to a conference and just said, we're gonna do this. Pack all the stuff we need, order it, and Quorum is great with supplying the different you know, unusual amounts and telling us about the expiration dates. It's a lot of work, but it's really worth it. It's so gratifying, and the kids absolutely love travel.
It just gives us this great bonded sense among our whole family of adventure and excitement and also normalcy.
But, you know, it is a lot of work, but we are able to do it, and it's extremely gratifying to be able to return to that thing that which we've loved so much, been a big part of our relationship and a big part of our work life.
Which one? You want a 50?
50 means middle.
Yeah, medium.
The first trip we took with Max to Paris was just, it changed everything. It just made it from, we are victims and we're burdened by this condition to, hey, we can deal with this, we can even thrive. I mean, it was just unbelievable to be there in front of the Eiffel Tower with Max, just, you know, wow, you know. It's just, yeah, it really changed our whole attitude about what we could do.
How about a 48?
No.
No?
Kai is Max's younger brother, roughly 2.5 years younger, and he's actually jealous of Max in many ways. He has his little stuffed animals that he'll do the hookup procedure on, and really imitates and processes all that kind of stuff that's happening by playing it out with his stuffed animals. And you know, he keeps his supplies, and he really imitates the whole process that Max goes through, and it's really sweet and cute. You know, Max says he's jealous of Kai because Kai doesn't have to be hooked up and have the tubes and do various other kinds of procedures that Max has to go through. But Kai says he's jealous of Max because Max, you know, doesn't wake up in the morning hungry. And Kai says, oh, it's so hard. I have to get up and go and get breakfast. And Max is already, you know, just coming off of his TPN overnight, and he doesn't have to worry about it. And he can go play with his Legos right away. Max has always been very interested from a very early age in taking on as much of his care as possible. You know, I think when he was 3 or 4 years old, he was wanting to do some of his dressings, and we really encouraged that. And, you know, even if he didn't do it right at all, we just kind of, you know, I thought it's just very important to let him get kind of control over his own situation. He is a take charge kind of kid, and you know, doesn't there's like 0% victim in Max. I mean, he is just completely, you know, his own guy. He's in charge, and so yeah, we can't get him to clean up his room, but on the other hand, he's
the boss of the goofballs.
Yeah, he's the king of the goofballs. He has a little group of friends, and yeah, he bosses them around, and they don't mind. He's just a really, really strong boy, and I think, you know, it's hard to say, but I think he does benefit from the perspective of having his medical condition, and he's also an extremely loving, loving boy. And one of the features of his goofball friends is a lot of hugging. He says how much he loves them. He loves his teacher. He has a list that he wrote out of all the things he loves. He just has a lot of really strong appreciation for life and for things that he really likes. And you got to think that there's a little bit of, you know, having that perspective from his medical condition in there that makes him really appreciate what he's got.
Right?
Like the...